Did you know that every church that exists also has an angel that is over that church? What about this? Every human being, every person who knows the Lord Jesus Christ, they got an angel next to them. The fact is, you don't just have one angel around you. It's a guardian army, baby. It's an entire army. Here's how it works. When God is about to make a decision over Tabernacle of Glory, when God decides, for example, I'm gonna give them a piece of property and I'm gonna give them that land cash, and I know that they don't have money to buy it. We didn't have $1. And the Lord said, I know they have nothing in the bag, but in the council of heaven, I declare that Tabernacle of Glory shall have a church. So what does God do? He called all the angels and said, my church needs a place. We gotta come up with a plan. We gotta come up with a solution. Somebody say glory.
Hello friends, how are you? It is a pleasure for me to be with you guys in HP. We've spent the entire month, last month, talking about the audacity of faith. And now we're coming to the closing of our study together. So we're going to look at a number of questions. Number one, read Acts chapter 4, verse 31. Acts chapter 4, verse 31. And two questions. Number one, what was the sign that God had given them that their prayer had been answered? When they prayed, what was the sign that God gave them that their prayer had been answered? Number two, has God ever given a sign to you after you have prayed? Has God ever given a sign to you after you had prayed? Okay, so take 15 minutes to discuss the signs that God has given to you, or share your testimony in that regard, and I'll come back. Thank you. Well, we'll continue with the audacity of faith. The second sign, Acts chapter 1, chapter 4, verse 31, gives us a second thing that happened. Before they were able to come out in boldness, first of all, the place was shaken, and secondly, they were filled with the Holy Spirit. Now, have you ever been filled with the Holy Spirit? So share that experience with your neighbor. If you've never been filled with the Holy Spirit, pray. Everyone in the group is going to pray that the Holy Spirit of God fills you. Take 15 minutes. We'll come right back. Well, number three, we talked about the audacity of faith. The audacity of faith leads you to take certain steps of faith for the Lord. Joshua, when he was crossing the Jordan, had to put his feet in the water before the water actually ceased, before the water was split in two in front of him. He had to put his foot in the water. Now, my question to you is, what act of faith are you planning to take after hearing that series of messages on the audacity of faith? God has given you the courage and the audacity. What act of faith are you planning to take after this series of messages? So take time to share with each other and pray for each other. And I'll come right back to close. Thank you. friends, it was a pleasure for me to be with you guys. I pray that the Lord blesses the step of faith that you're about to take. Remember, this Friday coming up is Shekinah night. Don't miss that opportunity. Friday it's going to be in Creole, and Saturday it's going to be in English. English Shekinah night, we're going to spend some time in prayer calling upon the Lord. And Sunday, it's Operation Andrew. Don't miss that. God bless you.
Have you checked out our social media platforms lately? If you haven't, you need to stay connected and updated with all the great things that God is doing at Tabernacle of Glory. Like us on Facebook. Follow us on Twitter and Instagram. And most importantly, subscribe to our YouTube channel, Shekinah TV. Thank you.